Hello friends, welcome to our channel Knowledge Amplifier, and in my this particular video I am going to discuss how we can apply the image processing concepts in medical science. Okay, so this is our first project related to medical science domain, and that is kidney stone detection. Okay, so first let me write CLC clear all, close all, warning off, like generally we write, and just run this once. Okay, now what I will do, I will go step by step, each line will be explained, we will do all together. Okay, so first of all, we will not specify one particular image. What we want user will select image from present anywhere in the local system. Okay, so for that I will write help UI get file. Okay, this is the function user interface. Using interface user interface, if I want to get file, then this is the command help UI get file. If you go below, here you will be getting one piece of code. Let me just copy this one. Okay, Control C, Control V. Okay, in engineering many time you have done this, Control C, Control V, no problem, right? So jokes apart, let's do something with this particular one. So this one can be used to browse only M file, because star dot M, dot M extension is used to pick only MATLAB code, but we want image, so I will just apply star dot star. Why not JPG? Because image can be PNG, image can be TIF, anything, TIFF file. Okay, so for that I am applying star dot star, so any image file can be picked up. Okay, now what I will do, I will write file name equal to string concatenation of C. What is generally file name? First path name and then file name, right? So I will concatenate path name and file name, that's all. Okay, let me clear the comment window, it is looking bad. So clear comment window is always good for programming, it will help you not to get confused, right? So now we are ready to take input image. I am writing A equal to, okay, I am read this file name, just you need to give, right? Control V, and I am show A. Let me show you how it is working actually. See, as soon as I run the code, it is opening this kind of window, and we are allowed to browse and take image anywhere present in our local system. It need not be the MATLAB current directory only. So here I am going to this particular folder and taking one image which is present in that folder. So this is one ultrasound image for kidney stone detection. Now this, you can understand that here only kidney stone might be present. Present or not, we don't know for the time being. We are doing image pre-processing. You can see this is the kidney part, right? Just recall the biology part, life science part you have studied up to class 10 at least, right? So we want this one only. We don't want this writing, this kind of scales. We have to remove this, and this removing modifications will come under image preprocessing. So we need to create one proper mask which we can put on this particular image to remove all this and keep only our this particular point of interest. So what we can do, obviously creating filter, okay, a logical operation you can understand quite simply in case of binary domain. So we'll convert our image from RGB to gray and gray to binary, like that will go, right? So A equal to, okay, let me keep in other variable, B equal to RGB to gray A. Okay, and then applying figure I am show B. Okay, let's check. Obviously you will be not getting any difference in between RGB image and grayscale image, because here in the RGB image also there is no coloring is there, right? So now what we can do, we have to convert this image to our binary image. Now binary image, let us check the histogram first. Okay, figure I am hist of B. To why I am checking the histogram, just to verify whether we can apply global thresholding or not. Okay, so here we are getting this kind of histogram. You can see it is not at all bimodal. Okay, there is no lobe in the lower part and the brighter part. Okay, so our global thresholding is going to fail. This time what we can do, we can apply adaptive thresholding, and another way is that from the pixel information we can try to get the particular threshold value using kind of trial and error method. So I am removing these particular two lines and I am writing im pixel info. Okay, this will give us pixel information for any xy data point, right? So I hope you are understanding and doing implementing simultaneously in MATLAB. Code will be posted in the description box or in the comment section. No need to worry about the code. So let me make this bigger. And see, if you move the mouse pointer, here you will be getting pixel coordinate and intensity. See, here the background is completely black, zero intensity. Okay, here if you just move, see, all the center part is brighter, but that is very small amount of pixels are present there. If you just take this particular part, which is also our region of interest, see, the actually brightness is very less, intensity is very small, 13, okay, 62, like that. Here it is increased 148, like that. Here might be, this might be one kidney stone, we don't know, 202, like that. Here again in the boundary side, 21, 20, 18, like that. So I am going to keep the threshold value for this particular image to convert to binary very less, okay. So AB variable I have used, I am taking C variable. Okay, C equal to IM binarize of B comma 20. I am keeping 20. Above 20, it will keep 1. Below 20, it will keep 0. Figure IM show C. Run this code. It will again give us opportunity to browse. I'll open this and what is happening? Let me just check. IM binarize C. It is coming completely black. Okay. Any pixel above the value 20 is going to be 1. Right? So why this logical is not working? IM binarize threshold value. Help IM binarize. B-I-N-A-R-I-Z. Let us check. I guess it takes values between 0 and 1. Let me verify. Global method, adaptive sensitivity. Oh, T must have value in between 0 and 1. Sorry. Then what we can do? 20 by 255 we can write. Hit enter. Let's run. See. Yes. Perfectly working binarization. Or else, if you don't want to implement like this, you can write simply B greater than 20. Whatever intensity will be greater than 20, that will be 1. Below that will be 0. Logical, right? Comparison based. So here I can run right like this also, run this, see, it is working. Now what we can do, see, in the image, this is our region of interest. See, let me just zoom this particular part. See, many holes are present here. So let us fill these holes using what? Using IM fill, right? So maybe D variable I can take. IM fill C comma holes. Okay, figure IM show D. Let me run this one. So see, now what happened, actually the holes part in the region of interest is filled. Along with that, one more beautiful observation you can have. See, here this writing part 2D, okay, G39, in the 9 also hole is present, in the D also hole is present. You can see, due to application of IM fill holes, all these D, hole of D, hole of 9 also filled, although that is not required. And now what we have to do, we have to remove these lines, these writings, this binary object present near to boundary, and this particular parts which are not actually connected with our original region of interest, right? So what we can do, we can simply apply BW area open one particular pixel value I will be giving, and if our any binary object is having lesser number of pixels compared to that, then it will be washed away, right? Now what BW area open, what value we can give? So here deciding that is very simple, because our region of interest is very huge. So suppose I am giving 1000 pixels, if it is for sure that our region of interest is having pixel more than 1000, right? So obviously these lines, these writings can be washed away, but anyway our region of interest will not. Okay, so based on that we can do maybe E variable, we can define E equal to BW area open, already discussed in detail, you can check my playlist for this, BW area open D comma 1000. Okay, then figure I am show E, run. So this is my original image. So see, eventually we are actually going towards our destination. Actually, we have got our filter. This is the filter, right? Now we have to put this on our RGB image. See, writings has gone away. These lines has gone away. Wonderful. Now what we have to do? We have to apply this on this original image. Which one? This one. So that we can have only this part, right? So how we can apply? One thing logically try to understand. This is what image? This is binary image. And our original image is what image? RGB image. When you want to multiply this binary mask on RGB image, in the red channel also you have to multiply, in the green channel also you have to multiply, in the blue channel also you have to multiply. So you have to repeat this three times. Okay, and how we can do that? For that, one interesting function is present in MATLAB, and that is called repmat. Okay, what it does, let me just show you. Repmat 10,2,3, I am just writing, see what it is going to give. Hit enter. It is going to give us one matrix having two rows, three columns with 10. So 10 is getting repeated, right? So here what we'll do, we will repeat our this mask, which is after we are getting after applying BW area open three times in for three channels. Okay, right? And we should get our pre-processed image. So pre-processed image, okay, equal to, what we can do, tell me, see, double of A. Why I am converting my image to double? Because you should always follow this whenever you are want to apply any arithmetic operation, that may be addition, that may be subtraction, that may be division, that may be multiplication, anything, convert to double, because you know that answer, in case of unsigned integer, it works only in integer domain, but when you are doing arithmetic operation, then you should convert to double, take the decimal, if required you can convert again back to unsigned integer, right? Okay, dot star for matrix operation. Okay, then I am going to use the repmat. What is our mask? E comma, so row and column no need to repeat, but for channel three times I need to repeat, for red channel one, for green channel one, for blue channel one. Okay, enter. Let's see, I will write figure I am show pre-processed image, run this code again. We can browse this, suppose you are browsing this. Okay, so here we are getting back this one only. So why this is happening? What is the problem? Why we are not getting our region of interest? Okay, so you can see in the workspace, pre-processed image is double data type. Sorry. So what we can do, we can convert this to unsigned integer 8 and our job will be done. Because in case of double data type, what is the problem? That any value greater than 1 or near to 1 will be considered as white. So obviously it is going to be taking complete white part in origin of interest. But see, when you are converting to unsigned integer 8, that time what happens? That time any value near to 255 is basically bright color, right? So let me close all the middle steps and see, actually we have completed our image pre-processing. What we have done? we have converted our this original image to this, where all these small writings has gone away, where this scaling has gone away, and we have extracted only our region of interest. So this is what is the concept of image pre-processing. See, everything is discussed. Filling the holes discussed, thresholding discussed, BW area open discussed. Just you need to apply step by step. Okay, some fundamental concept of MATLAB, basic idea for programming, whatever you study, when there you study Java, C, C++, Python, you remember some fundamental operation, right? Similarly here, RepMat, you need to remember. What is the difference between unsigned integer 8 and binary? When to convert, when not to. Okay, all these things discussed in several videos of my digital image processing. Just I am applying that step by step. So I hope you have understood this, enjoyed this. This is all for my this video. I'll be continuing this particular kidney stone detection project in my next video also. Till then, stay tuned. Code will be posted in the description or in the comment section. You can check. Thank you for watching.